Thanks, Aman. We welcome all the participants and the management of Dilip Buildcon for the Q2 FY19 earnings conference call. The call will be initiated by a brief management discussion on the earnings performance, followed by a Q&A. The management team of Dilip Buildcon is represented by Mr. Devendra Jain, Executive Director and CEO, Mr. Rohan Suryavanshi, Head Strategy and Planning, and Mr. Raja Ghosh, CFO. We would now begin the call with the opening remarks from Mr. Rohan. Over to you, Rohan.
Thanks a lot, Pranjal. First of all, I, along with the whole DBL family, would like to welcome all our investors and our partners in this conference call for the quarter ending 30th September 2018. It is my great pleasure and honor to be able to host this call and update all our partners of the important milestones we achieved this year, this quarter, and our expectations for the rest of the year. I hope you guys would have had a chance to look at our results and the presentation that we've uploaded. We apologize for the delay, but the board meeting ran a little later. But we've tried to put as much details in the presentation, and we've tried to make it as informative as possible for you guys to also look at, you know, the historical data as well as where we're trying to go for the future. Let me first touch upon, you know, some of the recent developments in the industry, and then I'll talk about the company updates. So, you know, let me start with the historical numbers. So the construction of highways in FY18 reached almost 10,000 kilometers, which was constructed at an average pace of about 26.93 kilometers per day. Now, the total road length of roads constructed under Prime Minister Gram Sadak Yojana was about 47,000 kilometers in 2017-18. Now, we are expecting a construction pace to reach for the national highways. We are expecting it to reach about 12,000 kilometers this year. And more or less, you know, the government seems to be to be very supportive and looking for that target. In terms of awarding, the national government had, you know, fixed a target of almost 20,000 kilometers of roads to be that they wanted to award it. We don't know if that much will be done or not, but at least last year they did about 17,000 kilometers. We feel, you know, they should be able to hit somewhere in around that number. Because as of now, there are about 1 lakh crores of orders which have already been floated by the government. In this, the share of EPC projects is about 55%. Now, if you look at the earlier part of this year, obviously ordering has been tepid, but that's been the same trend for the last few years. The government awarded about a little less than 15,000 crores of orders in this financial year till now, out of which DBL share was about 8%. So we are hoping as more and more orders come in, we're expecting to bag some more good orders this year. As you all know, the government has decided to invest about 7 trillion rupees for the construction of new highways and roads for the next 5 years under the Bharatmala Pariyojana. We are very hopeful of the government coming very close to this number, because they've already started work on a lot of these projects in terms of all the DPR detailed project reports that need to be made. So there is a very hectic work that's happening there as well. The delay that's been happening from the government side has been more to do with, you know, their conditions precedent that they need to fulfill. But overall, I think order inflow should be very robust for the next few years, with at least a 15,000 kilometer of order flow that we are expecting. Now let me come to the company's numbers. If you look at our net order book as of 30th September, it stands at about 23,935 crores. Now, 88.37% of this order book is constituted by roads, highways and bridges. Urban development projects contribute about 0.37%. Mining contributes about 11.26%. Another way to look at this is 91% of our order book is given by the central government and 9% is given by state governments, which are the state government of Maharashtra and Punjab. So these are the only two state government, and with Punjab government, we recently bagged a large MDO project. So that is that. We were very successful in, you know, winning good projects this year. We won a coal overburden removal project worth 717 crores in the state of MP. We won an MDO contract in the state of Jharkhand, which is worth about 32,156 crores at current price, excluding GST. We also won, you know, our first metro project which were Bhopal and Indore metro projects. So we were also very, very excited about doing our first metro projects. We're also very happy to inform everyone that we've received the final sanction for 8 of our HAM projects. And we already have the in-principle sanction for 3 more projects, which we are expecting to receive the final approval within this month. And another project will, the final project that's the balance HAM, the first one HAM project that is left, we will should receive it within the month of December. I am also very happy to inform, you know, all our investors and partners that DBL was the recipient of multiple awards in this quarter. We were given award by the Construction World magazine as the fastest growing construction company in the large category award and India's top challenger award. So in both the categories, we picked, you know, all, you know, the well-known established companies in the space. And this was selected by a very eminent jury comprising of the who's who of the industry. Similarly, we also won 4 prestigious awards at the 8th Construction Annual Week Award, where we won the Infrastructure Company of the Year Award, Infrastructure Person of the Year Award, to Mr. Devendra Jain, our CEO. We won the Road Contractor of the Year of the Award, and we also won the Road and Highway Project of the Year Award to our Amritsar Tarantaran project. So we're very happy that, you know, the good work that the company has been doing has been recognized by all and sundry, and this was again judged by a very eminent jury, where we won all the categories that we had, you know, participated in. We also announced the completion of 2 road projects in the state of Maharashtra. Both of these road projects were completed very well ahead of time. Both of them were 2-year projects where we were completing them, one project 280 days before time and one project 210 days before time, and winning an early completion bonus of 14.4 crores and 14.6 crores in one and both of them. Let me, you know, move on to the results right now. So I'm very pleased to announce that the total revenue of the company on a standalone basis is 1636 crores in Q2 FY19 as against 1585 crores in quarter 2 FY18. This is a growth of 3.3%. Our standalone EBITDA for quarter 2 FY19 has been 294 crores as against 288 crores in quarter 2 FY18, a growth of 2%. And the standalone profit after tax stood at 80 crores in quarter 2 FY19 as opposed to 115 crores in quarter 2 FY18. If I move on to the result for the half year ended 30th September, the total revenue on a standalone basis is 4082 crores in H1 FY19. As against 3252 crores in H1 FY18. This is a growth of 26%. Our standalone EBITDA for H1 FY19 has been at 737 crores as against 591 crores in H1 FY18, which is a growth of 24%. And our standalone PAT stood at 336 crores in H1 FY19 as against 238 crores in H1 FY18, which is a growth of 41%. I'm also very pleased to announce that our finance cost is reduced from 6.8% to 5.95% in the first half. Like we have demonstrated in the past as well, this improvement will continue, as has been the trend in the last few years as well. As on September 30th, 2018, the net debt on a standalone basis is 3447 crores, and the net working capital has reduced from 125 days in quarter 2 FY18 to 96 days in quarter 2 FY19. Also, very happy to inform that our net debt to equity ratio has come down from, in the last few years, so from 2.27 in FY16 to 1.24 in H1 FY19. And we are very confident that we will reduce to 1 or below in this financial year at the end of it. Now, what we've also done in our presentation is divided our debt into 2 parts, into working capital debt and equipment debt. The reason we've done that is because, unlike most of our peers, we own all our equipment. So that debt also comes onto our books. If we do a peer-to-peer, an apple-to-apple comparison, we wanted to show that how, you know, our working capital debt looks versus equity. So while the net debt to equity is 1.24, which includes both the working capital and equipment debt, if I only look at the working capital debt to equity ratio, it's 0.77. This has all happened when the company has grown in to 4x in the last 4-5 years. So, you know, this is a very, very impressive way that the company has grown without raising an external equity and going on the kind of growth that it has done using internal accruals. Now let me talk about our revenue guidance for FY19. It remains at 10,000 crores as we had indicated earlier as well. We've also put our revenue split between first half and second half for the last few years in the presentation as well. And it has been consistent in the range of 40% to 60%. Even this year, as expected to us, the revenue is flowing in the same way. And we're very confident that, you know, the numbers that we said is we are well on track to achieve it. Our EBITDA margins, as we have indicated in the past few years, should also be in the same range of 17% to 18% as you've guided. And again, our focus, as it has always been, will be to win good projects and also diversify our order book into not just geographically, but also through other sectors that we've already done and showcased in this financial year, as with all the orders that we've won. This year is turning out to be a very interesting year for us, and we are very, very confident that, even on the overall, when we look at the end of the financial year, the debt numbers that we are looking at right now, all this will come down. And we should be in the range of last year's debt numbers only. So even when we would have increased our top line by that much, we are expecting our debt to be remaining absolutely at the same neutral level. So till date, we've already won, finally, about 6,000 crores of projects. And we are expecting to win another 4,000 to 6,000 crores of incremental projects. And that's how much, as you indicated at the start of the year, that we'll be doing. With this, we now open the floor for question and answers. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may press star and one on their touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Participants are requested to use handsets for asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. The first question is from the line of Parikshit Kanpal from HDFC Securities. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. Congratulations for achieving the FC of the entire HAM portfolio.
Thank you very much, Parikshit.
Was there any bonus in this quarter?
Bonus wasn't there in this quarter, but post that we received projects.
Two projects.
In two projects that we've done, it's about 29 crores that I mentioned earlier on this call as well.
Okay, and how much will be the cumulative bonus running as of now for all the projects which are under execution?
Sir, for this financial year, at the end of it, we expect our bonus to be in a similar line as we've had in the past few years. So, it should be, we're expecting it to be at least in the range of 100 crores.
But so coming to the debt levels now, this quarter there has been because of the monsoon and seasonally weak quarter, I mean there has been a dip in execution quarter on quarter. YOY there has been a growth, but for that level of execution, why has the debt gone up by 360 crores? Because I am seeing your inventory has increased by 120, and your trade payables have almost decreased by 264 crores. So if you can throw some color on why that has gone up during this quarter.
So we are investing in all our sites. See, all the 20 projects that we won, none of them have an appointed date right now, but the investment is being made by the company already on all these sites. So the investment that is going, until unless we have that, so right now we are expecting, so there is about 2,000 crores of mobilization advance that the company has to receive in this financial year. So once only the appointed dates come, and only then we will receive that. But till that time, when deploying all our manpower, our equipment, giving royalty to the government, crushing all those things, setting up projects, all those things are taking up capital, and this is where it is going. Also, investing in equipment as well. So all those things is the reason why you will see that number going up right now, but which will come down in quarter three and quarter four. Quarter four, you will see a major decrease in this.
So what is the pre-mobilization of all these HAM projects, 12 HAM projects? How much you would have invested?
10% on all projects we get mobilization advance. So even for all the HAM and all the EPC projects, so we are awaiting those projects to start. So once that happens, we will get the mobilization advance.
No. I'm asking, sir, how much you have mobilized? You said that the debt has gone up because you have already started preparing for the camp and other things. Pre-construction activities have started on all these sites. So I'm asking, how much would have been the outlay on these sites which have still not started from your site?
So 400-500 crores has at least gone in all those sites.
Basically, which explains the increase in debt.
Yeah, yeah. Because till the time mobilization advance doesn't come, as is our strategy, we always start working once we get that. So, you know, from pre-cutting to everything, which we mentioned earlier as well, that we are putting money in all these project sites, and which is why this will... So once the mobilization advance starts coming back, you will see this reduction happening. So for all the... See, what has happened last year is all the projects that we won happened in the last month, most of them. So all of them... So this is a unique year where all the projects were won in the last month, so all of the preparation is going at the same time. So otherwise, typically, you would have, money being rotated from one project, then, you know, you have another project. So there's always constant rotation happening. But because there is, you know, all projects are taking up capital at the same time, without any capital having come in from mobilization advance. This is why you see this right now.
Okay. And so this balance, this HAM order book is around 11,249, the ETC value. So in our guidance of 10,000 crores of revenues for this year, how much of this revenue we're building in from the HAM projects?
Balance here.
Give us a second. About 2,500 crores or so will come from HAM projects.
No. So I'm not saying that. So there's 12 HAM projects which are under FC. So I'm asking you how much of that you're expecting to convert to revenues in this financial year for.
Around 1,000 crore ka revenue in naye projects mein se aayega. 12 projects. Balance financial year में
ठीक है सर एक खाली लास्ट चीज ये श्रेम का 131 करोड़ का ये FY20 में पोस्टपोन हो गया सर इनफ्लोस
नहीं वो पोस्टपोन इसलिए हुआ कि जो श्रेम का जितना भी पेमेंट था वो माइलस्टोन वाइज था तो उसमें जो दो सीओडी हमारे कर्नाटक के तीन प्रोजेक्ट की सीओडी दो महीने आगे बढ़ी थी और गुना ब्यावरा जो हमारा एक प्रोजेक्ट था उसकी सीओडी मार्च से जून में पोस्टपोन हुई थी तो अकॉर्डिंगली वो पैसा आगे बढ़ गया
ओके सर थैंक यू एंड ऑल द बेस्ट
थैंक यू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन is from the line of Amar Sowase from as an individual investor. Please go ahead.
Yeah, sir. Thank you for the opportunity and congratulations for the best set of results. So my first question is recently, I mean, in last month, you announced that you are going to diversify your portfolio, and you said that we are going to tie up with the IOC, Indian Oil Company, for procuring the some oil products for the bitumen and providing infrastructure services, which you said in the first corporate announcement. And in the second corporate announcement, you said that we are going to diversify in oil industry where we will be as a service provider.
Yeah, I understand your question. So let me categorically tell you that we've never told that we are going to get into oil, exploration or anything. It was just that legal language that went in, they had to put the secretary and team had put all those things. Now, first, let me categorically tell you, and we have explained this in the past as well, that it is not our intention to be in this business. We've told that the only reason this was done because one of our largest suppliers, Indian Oil, gave this service to us because we are their largest client, and they said they wanted to open this along with DBL. So this is an investment, and this is an investment that the IOCL is doing at one of our project sites. So we have no intention to get into this business. So this was just done to accommodate the request of a large client, and that's it. No, I had no plan to be into any exploration or to be opening more petrol stations or anything like that. So that's that.
But what will be the services we are going to provide them as a construction?
So we are not providing any services. We are not providing them any services. They just want to build a petrol station. That's all that they're doing. That's all. And they're giving it to DBL. We are not providing any services. Well, yeah.
Thank you, Ms. Samar. May we request to join the question queue for any follow-ups as we have several participants waiting for their turn. Thank you. The next question is from the line of Venkatesh from Citibank. Please go ahead.
Sir, आपका अगर presentation देखे तो उसमें ऐसा लग रहा है कि आपको इस quarter में 160 करोड़ श्रेम ग्रुप से मिला ये सही है?
बिल्कुल सही है। आ चुका है।
तो आपको जब 570 करोड़ fourth quarter FY18 में मिला था, आपने standalone results में एक छोटा सा loss book किया था, क्योंकि आपने बोला था कि part of the portfolio has been sold below book, part has been sold above book, on an average it is slightly above book. तो इस क्वार्टर में जब आपको 160 करोड़ का पैसा मिला है तो आपका इस क्वार्टर में लॉस या गेन कुछ भी बुक नहीं है ऐसा क्यों है
क्योंकि सर वो जो उसके जो शेयर हमने बेस्ट टाइम में बताया था कि जब तक शेयर पूरे प्लेज नहीं हो पाएंगे तो हम वी आर अवेटिंग हमारे जो जो बैलेंस शेयर जो ट्रांसफर होने हैं जब वो हो जाएगा तब होगा। वो जो शेयर हमें बैंक से निकालने थे और इनसे निकालने थे अथॉरिटी से वो पूरा अभी आया नहीं, जब वो आ जाएगा तो दैट टाइम सो आई थिंक विद इन दिस मंथ और सो वो सारे आ जाने चाहिए तो वो सारी डील उस टाइम वो क्या जाएगा। सो दैट इज स्टिल अंडर प्रोसेस जी।
ठीक है
सो टेम्पररी है, जिस दिन वो सारे जो शेयर जो बैलेंस उनके शेयर हम उनको ट्रांसफर कर देंगे उस दिन वो रिवर्स हो जाएगा।
वी आर वेटिंग फॉर द बैंक्स परमिशन।
ओके दूसरी चीज है, आपको इस क्वार्टर का जो रेवेन्यू आया है एग्जीक्यूशन ये आपके खुद के इंटरनल रन रेट के कम है या इज इट इन लाइन, कि मतलब आपको पूरा कॉन्फिडेंस है आपके वो 10,000 करोड़ के रेवेन्यू गाइडेंस पे?
हम लोगों ने जो गाइडेंस भी दिया था वो यही दिया था कि हम लोग ऑलमोस्ट इतना फर्स्ट हाफ में हम लोग करीब 4,000 करोड़ का रेवेन्यू करेंगे और सेकंड हाफ में हम लोग लगभग 6,000 करोड़ का रेवेन्यू करेंगे, एकदम इन लाइन है वो।
ओके सर एक आखिरी क्वेश्चन है, 10,000 करोड़ तो इस आप कुछ बोल रहे थे
वो पिछले चार साल का भी आप ट्रेंड देखोगे तो हमने प्रेजेंटेशन में वही डाला है दिखाने के लिए कि हमारे प्रेजेंटेशन जिस तरह से हमारे पिछले चार साल का फर्स्ट हाफ और सेकंड हाफ का रहा है रेवेन्यू उसी तरह से रहा है, दिस इज इन लाइन विद आवर एक्सपेक्टेशन।
ओके एक आखिरी क्वेश्चन है, आपका इस साल का 10,000 करोड़ का रेवेन्यू गाइडेंस है, एनी थॉट ऑन हाउ FY20 इज लाइकली टू बी, बिकॉज हाफ ईयर अभी हो चुका है, कि आर यू स्टिल टारगेटिंग 25% काइंड ऑफ ग्रोथ और आर यू प्लानिंग, बिकॉज आपका 8 फाइनेंशियल क्लोजर हो चुका है 8 प्रोजेक्ट्स का, तो आर वी ऑन ट्रैक टू कंटिन्यू ग्रोइंग एट अ सिमिलर पेस नेक्स्ट ईयर ऑल्सो, और इज इट टू अर्ली टू टेक अ कॉल ऑन दैट?
So it's too early to give anything on that, but let me assure you कि हमारा जो अजेंडा है our focus is an overall company के लिए जो best है उस पर हमारा focus है कि we want to make sure our debt numbers you know continue to remain tepid or fall down, we want to improve our debt equity ratio, we want to work on these। आप देखोगे हमारा asset utilization का ratio आप देखोगे तो वो हमारा improve, दो पिछले तीन साल का आप देखेंगे तो asset utilization more than double हो चुका है, it's from 2.2 it's gone to almost 4.75 और इस साल के एंड में ये और भी ऊपर होके हो जाएगा, कैश फ्लो हमारा और जनरेशन, तो हमारा वो सब का फोकस रहेगा। तो वी विल टेक अ कॉल व्हेन हमारे जो आएगी एंड ऑफ द ईयर तब पे हम आपको बात करेंगे।
ओके एक आखिरी क्वेश्चन था आपका, इस क्वार्टर में करंट टैक्सेस में एक आई थिंक 12.8 करोड़ का कुछ छोटा सा नंबर है जो पुराने साल का टैक्स का है, अब थोड़ा एक्सप्लेन करेंगे ये एक्स्ट्रा आइटम क्या आया है, थोड़ा डिटेल थोड़ा पर्सपेक्टिव देखेंगे तो इट विल हेल्प अस।
सर एक सेकंड मैं चेक करूँ आप कौन सा नंबर बोले, जस्ट गिव मी वन सेकंड। सर वो करंट ईयर का ही, पुराने ईयर का कोई नहीं है जो आप नंबर देख रहे हैं।
नहीं इसमें कुछ है नोट नंबर आई थिंक 6, द कंपनी हैड मेड एन एप्लीकेशन टू द इनकम टैक्स सेटलमेंट कमीशन विद रिस्पेक्ट टू असेसमेंट ईयर 2007-08, तो उसमें कुछ सेटलमेंट में आपको थोड़ा आप कुछ प्रोवाइड कर रहे हैं तो ये थोड़ा एक्सप्लेन करेंगे ये हुआ क्या था, दैट यू हैव मेड अ प्रोविजन ऑफ 1,277 lakhs in the quarter which is reflected under current tax, note 6।
ये हमने ऑलरेडी पे कर चुके हैं पहले ही सेटलमेंट कमीशन को बहुत पहले ही, और वी आर रेड टू रिसीव द फाइनल ऑर्डर, सो जब एक डिपार्टमेंट जब हमें आ जाएगा तो देन वी विल टॉक अबाउट और पूरा जो भी रहेगा करस्पॉन्डिंग आपको आगे बता देंगे। सो ये हम तो ऑलरेडी पे कर चुके हैं।
आप मतलब वही मैं समझ में नहीं आ रहा, आपने ये पे कब किया और आपने इस क्वार्टर में क्यों प्रोवाइड किया मुझे वही, दैट इज द क्वेश्चन बेसिकली, वाई यू हैव प्रोवाइडेड दिस इन द करेंट क्वार्टर इफ यू हैव ऑलरेडी पेड फॉर इट।
एक मिनट मेरी टैक्स टीम विल एक्सप्लेन टू यू, प्रतीक विल एक्सप्लेन टू यू।
ड्यू टू द सेटलमेंट कमीशन ऑर्डर वी हैव पेड दैट 12 point something crores टू द इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट एंड वी आर येट टू रिसीव द फाइनल ऑर्डर फ्रॉम द लोकल इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट, वी हैव ऑलरेडी पेड दैट टैक्स। दिस विल क्लोज आफ्टर द रिसीव आफ्टर वी विल रिसीव द फाइनल ऑर्डर फ्रॉम द लोकल इनकम टैक्स डिपार्टमेंट।
So it is made then, abhi ka?
That quarter 2017. September 17. September 17 likha hua hai, usne thoda
kaha.
Galat padha.
Haan, aapne galat padha. Venkati ji, apan ek baar isko off, when aap samajh lenge, 17, September 17 ka disclosure hai ye.
Okay.
हाँ ये सितंबर 17 का डिस्क्लोजर है,
अच्छे से पढ़िए उसमें 17 सितंबर 17 लिखा हुआ है वेंकट जी।
हाँ
I understand.
And it says that lakhs made in that quarter. So I think if you read again, it will be clear.
Or if you need to offline, we will talk about it in case there is something else.
Yeah. Thank you, Mr. Venkatesh. May I request to join the question queue for any follow-ups. We have the next question from the line of Aditya Mongia from Kotak Securities. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. My question was related to the guidance for this year for revenue.
Aditya, your question is coming from behind.
Better for you?
Yes, it's better.
Yeah, so what I was asking was that the guidance for FY19, which is 10,000 crores, you're saying 6,000 crores is going to come in the second half, of which 1,000 crores is basically going to come from the HAM projects, which I get to start execution. Now, which means that the remaining 5,000 crores has to come from your existing backlog. Now, if I take away the projects, which are the HAM projects which I get to start, it is a very high ask rate from the remaining backlog to be getting 5,000 crores in the second half. So just thought if you can give more color on the downside risks, if any, to the guidance for FY19 revenues.
So it's not a very high risk. Everything that we are telling you, our ek-ek projects, our revenue, jo aage ka plan, uske hisab se de rahe hain. So there is nothing, like even if you look at historically, whatever guidance that we kept continue to give, it's after careful planning of each and every project. And we track projects on a daily basis. It's not ki wo monthly track ho raha hai or quarterly ho raha hai. So everything is tracked on a daily basis. So every number that we are giving to you is sacrosanct and has been in the case in the past as well. So you can be rest assured on that. If you want to discuss, understand project by project, that's a discussion later that we can do it offline rather than doing it here. But the guidance is pretty much intact. There is no key from that part.
Sure, got that. Related question, FY20, while you're not giving a guidance, if you can just give some sense of this 1,000 crore number, which was the number that he was quoting for HAM project FY19 execution remaining part, how much can this number be next year?
Sir, it's too early right now. We will talk about it at a later point.
Okay. The last question from my side. We've booked 150 crores of cash flows from the Shrem transaction this year. It doesn't appear that your investments have gone anywhere from the March 2018 numbers. So is that also a concomitant liability at this point of time, or how has that transaction been booked on the balance sheet?
I think that will be under liability only that we are holding, because those assets, until unless we are able to transfer those shares, that is all held under non-current liability. So
should
once the shares will be transferred, then it will be then it will move.
Got that. So essentially, there's an asset and a liability right now. Asset is the cash which is coming. Liability is that you have to transfer assets over time. Those were the questions for now. I'll join back in the queue for more questions. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. A reminder to our participants, anyone who wishes to ask a question at this time, they may please press star and one. We have the next question from the line of Shravan Shah from Dolat Capital. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thank you. Sir, regarding the revenue guidance that you are not giving for FY20, if I am not wrong, we have earlier given a 25% guidance for FY20. We are saying that we will give at an appropriate time. Just trying to understand what is stopping us to give a guidance for FY20.
Shravan ji, aap agar hamari order book dekhenge, to abhi lagbhag 24,000 crore ki order book hai hamare paas balance. Wo lagbhag 6,000 crore ka revenue hum balance bache hue financial year mein karenge. Wo lagbhag 5 to 6,000 crore ke project agar hum jeetenge, to agar aap hamara past record se calculate karenge, to minimum 15% ka aap guide maan sakte ho ki itna increment hamare top line mein agle saal hoga hi hoga. Hum early isliye keh rahe hain ki hamare financial closures ek baar ho jayenge, sari appointed dates aa jayengi agle 2 mahino mein, to hum log ekdam fine tune karke jo hamara past history raha hai ki jab bhi humne koi guidance diya hai to wo bilkul micro level pe guidance diya hai jo kabhi bhi fail nahi hua hai, isliye hum log usko thoda aage bol rahe hain, lekin aap minimum 10 to 15% aap increment hamari top line mein leke chal sakte ho FY20 ke liye.
Okay, and ये सब HAM project का sir जी next by December end appointed date आ सकता है और कितने तक कितने का appointed date December तक आ जाएगा?
देखिए अभी सबके अभी हम लोगों ने जो declaration किया है out of 12 8 projects के financial closure हो चुके हैं, बचे हुए 4 projects के financial closure month end तक और बचे हुए कुछ 2 projects जो बचेंगे 15 December तक हो जाएंगे. लेकिन अभी जो appointed date आएगा वो up to December out of 12 सिर्फ 4 projects का appointed date आएगा. January में another 4 projects का आएगा और बचे हुए 4 projects का land available पे depend करेगा कि वो February या March में आएगा या कुछ project April में भी जा सकते हैं उसमें.
Okay, okay. And sir, capex first half में हमने कितना किया है and full year का अभी कितना है अपना capex का?
105 करोड़ का हम लोग first half में capex कर चुके हैं.
And for full year, how much we are targeting?
वही 400-500 के बीच का, 400 से 500 करोड़ के आसपास के बीच का हमारा, है ना? ठीक.
200
का
clear
बोलना
है. So,
hello. Yeah, yeah.
उसी के हिसाब से जो दिया हुआ
है
वही गाइडेंस के इन लाइन है.
सो नहीं, अर्लियर वी हैव सेड 400 करोड़, नाउ वी आर सेइंग 400 टू 500 करोड़, एम आई राइट?
हमने रोड का बोला था, माइनिंग का हमने अलग बोला हुआ है, तो वो उसके ऊपर और जाएगा, जिस हमारा 200 करोड़ के आसपास का जाएगा. हमने माइनिंग का भी जो हम जो प्रोजेक्ट्स ले रहे हैं तो वो उसका और अलग जाएगा.
थैंक यू मिस्टर शाह.
हमने पहले बताया.
या मे बी रिक्वेस्ट टू जॉइन द क्वेश्चन की फॉर एनी फॉलो अप्स. Thank you. We have the next question from the line of Kondanya from JM Financial. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi sir. Thanks for taking my question. Hello.
Yes sir, thank you very much.
Yeah. Sir, I just want to understand from your point that like, we still have, I think, 4 HAM projects maybe where we need financial projects to be done. So just want to understand if there are any HAM projects where we haven't done the financial closure within the stipulated time and what's it like?
Sir, there is no HAM project that we are not doing within stipulated time. The condition is that the government also has to fulfill its condition precedence and we have to fulfill. Like we mentioned earlier as well, that the land, you know, and acquisition, everything that needs to happen, some of these projects will only start in March and April. So we are not in delay in any of these projects. This is all being done within time.
Yeah, so that brings to my second question, sir. So what is the land status in our projects, like for the HAM projects?
Sir, it is different for each and every project. It is different for each and every project. And when we sign for HAM projects, whenever you sign with the government, they need to provide 80% land. And in EPC projects, that they need to provide 90% land when the appointed date comes. So whenever dates we are telling you, on those dates, we should have in that range of land available.
Yeah, so you spoke of 4 projects. You said that, you know, for 4 projects, we'll receive appointed date in December, right? So what's the land status in these projects? What are these projects, you know, if you can throw some light on this?
Appointed date, we are taking 4 in December. This means that if we have 80% land, we will get the appointed date. That's the condition precedence from government.
Okay, sir. So what are these projects, sir?
Meaning?
Matlab, you want to name the projects?
Yeah, names of these projects.
The one project is the Anandapuram Anakapalli from Andhra Pradesh. Second project is from Karnataka Chalkheri Bairapura. Third project is from Odisha Chandikol Bhadrak. And fourth project is the Rima Sidi Tunnel project.
Okay, thanks. Thank you. Sir, my second question is on the interest rates at which we are getting the HAM projects. I mean, the financial closure. What is the interest rate at which we are getting the financial closure? And how has been the trend like? I mean, because we have seen some stress from NBFCs and all that. So how has been the scenario like?
All the projects that we are doing is below 10 in all the projects that our financial closure is happening. So we are seeing it at a decent trend. And most of our almost all of our projects are being funded by banks only. So we have no problems. And they're already all closed, like we mentioned.
So how has been the response by banks, or are they, you know, Ganga about the road sectors, funding, or how are they like? I mean, because few players are highlighting stress that, you know, about 50 projects in general. I'm speaking in a macro scenario, from a macro perspective, that close to 50 HAM projects are yet to receive financial closure. So, just trying to understand how the funding is like.
Sir, I think all the top players in the industry should not have no problem. While there are challenges because of, you know, where the whole banking system and possibly the, you know, other financial this thing is. But like, you know, we are already through, and similarly, I think all the other good players are already through. So if you want to understand more on that, I think you should be speaking to financial institutions and how they're thinking about the rest of the portfolio. I can speak about how we are doing. I can't answer for how others are faring.
Thank you, Mr. Kondinya. May I request to join the question queue for any follow-ups. Thank you. We have the next question from the line of Anupam Gupta from IIFL. Please go ahead.
So just one figure I want. For the 12 HAM projects, which for the new ones, what is the ETC cost which is sitting in your order book? Hello?
It's somewhere around 12,000 crores, sir.
12,000 crores, okay. And equity which you have mentioned is around 1321 crore, right? For all those 12.
Yeah, it's in that range, sir. Yes.
Okay, fine. Okay, thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Amit Sharma from ICICI Bank. Please go ahead.
Yeah. Just one question. I wanted to know if your share price has increased to around 17%. So can you throw some light on that? Hello?
Sorry, sir, what?
I just wanted to have some light on the increasing share pledge. Your share pledge increased to around 17% from 6% earlier. So what's the reason behind it?
We've already done last quarter to quarter. जो हमने आपको declare किया वो सी का last quarter का इसमें वही 17% भी होता ही है. So share pledge is there only, and we've told earlier as well that there is no new facility or anything that we've taken. It is only for older, you know, BGs and all. Yeah, it's in last quarter also it was the same. There is no, there's barely any change.
Oh, but it, on year-on basis, it has increased. So, like, 2-3 quarters back, it was around 6%, right? If I'm not wrong.
Sir, I think if you go back and to the last year, maybe on to the previous calls, you'll get to know why. Hello?
Hello? Yeah, so I just wanted to...
If you go back to the earlier this thing, you will get to know the purpose for this was we had given it to get the bank guarantees, as we have explained on the earlier calls as well. That these were given because we were taking bank guarantee. So there was no, so we haven't taken any personal borrowing, just to let you know, and there is no fund-based borrowing that has been done. These are only to give bank guarantees for all these HAM projects.
Yes. Okay.
No, any, no fund-based borrowing has been done, neither has been any borrowing done for personal basis. It's only been for bank guarantees for the HAM projects, which we will, you know, which we should come down at the end of this coming quarter. We should have this all come down. And anyway, this is a small portion of the overall promoter holding.
Thank you. We have the next question from the line of Manish Goyal from Enam Holdings. Please go ahead.
Yeah, very good evening, sir. Just wanted a clarification. In your initial remarks, you had mentioned that the debt level will be restored to the similar level of March 18, which was around 2,800 crores. Is it right, sir?
Yes, sir. It is our endeavor to bring down debt level there or below that. It is that's what we are trying to do.
Okay. So this, so for this 2,800 to achieve 2,800 crores debt from current 3,400 crores, this factors how much of mobilization advance we would get by March.
Give us one second. So the total mobilization advance that we were targeting is 2,000 crores, like we mentioned earlier as well, for all our projects. So some of it has, very little part of it has come. Now the rest that we expect in larger part, like once the appointed date for all the projects will come, only then we will get this money. So once, as in that happens, and the timing of it, that happens. So, which is why we're basing all our calculations on how much mobilization advance will come through, how things will look then. And that's why we're keeping it, giving you a range right now.
So, you are factoring entire 2,000 crores to come in by March?
Yes, sir, and, we are factoring all of that.
And as well as from the SREM, roughly 320 crores, which you are expecting in second half.
Yes, sir. We are expecting that as well.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Deepak Potar from Sapphire Capital. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thank you very much, sir, for the opportunity. So my question pertains to your basically tax. What's the effective tax rate we are looking at for FY19?
Sir, about 25% plus is what we are looking at the effective tax rate for this financial year.
25% plus. And as I see in the first half, I think we the taxes is barely anything, right? So it will be backloaded to the second half, basically the entire thing?
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. So, but what is the reason of this differences? Basically, in the first half, there will be no barely any taxes, but in the second half you will load that first half tax as well to the second half.
Just one sec, my team will answer.
Due to the reduction of the ATIA sites.
Hmm? Come again, sir?
Due to the reductions of ATIA sites.
Mm-hmm.
It's already under section ATIA.
Okay.
So, during the last quarter to this quarter, the number of sites will, from March 18 to this first half, the number of sites got reduced. That's why this difference comes.
Okay.
As the number of sites keep on reducing, the tax, where we got ATI benefit, the tax will keep on increasing. That's the point.
So from third quarter, will be like more than full, more than 33% tax rate, from third quarter onwards, because you have to compensate for the tax rate.
No. It won't be more than that. We still have a lot of MAT credit left. We also have about 400 crore plus of MAT credit left. So this will, we will be consuming that as well. And the effective tax rate, like I mentioned, will be about 25% also.
Thank you. Mr. Poddar, may we request you to join the question queue for any follow-ups. Also, any participants like to ask a question at this time, they may please press star and one. We have the next question from the line of Chetan Cholera from Pragya Equities. Please go ahead.
Yeah, sir. I just have one question, how we are managing, since I look at the other infrastructure project companies, how we are managing our receivables, they are getting only after going to arbitration and all that processes. So what we are doing differently than the other companies? So I just want to understand.
Nisha, that is not there with every EPC company. I think what you're talking about specifically might be more to do with, the last infra players, of the last era, which is HPC and Gavin. If we talk about, the companies in this cycle, most of us, have a robust receivable cycle and we're doing pretty well. So even right now, if you keep on executing, the money which gets stuck with government is where you have arbitration or litigation with the government. So as of now, on DBL's balance sheet, we don't have any arbitration or litigation against the government, against the national government. We are not having any of that on our balance sheet. So all of this you see is, current running receivables projects that are being done. It gets approved and all, we keep getting money from it. So that's why we are doing our job of just executing projects.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Devashish Mazumdar from Edelweiss. Please go ahead.
Thank you very much for the opportunity. I have only one question. Loss in... Hello? Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Very audible. Please.
Yeah. The one question that I have is this loss in momentum of revenue in quarter two, is it something only linked to monsoon or it is something structural that we are seeing? Where from I'm coming, I'm giving you some example. So Vijayawada Machilipattam, the project that you have reported a revenue of 142 crore in Q1 and only 9 crore in Q2. And there are multiple example project after project. So is there only linked to monsoon or something different we need to read about it?
So Devashish ji, aapne particular jis project ka naam liya, agar aap pata karenge to rainfall data is more than 1500 mm in that area, Vijayawada Machilipattam. So obviously ye jitne bhi projecto ka revenue kam hua hai, this is the only region, the rainfall region sara ka sara. Aur particularly kya hota hai ki hamare paas jo particular work hote hain wo kis locality mein, kis financial year mein hai, uske karan uska impact padta hai. To abhi agar aap dekhenge to Goa mein hum log project karenge. Goa is the 5500 mm rainfall area. तो वहां पे हमारा प्रोजेक्ट है तो वहां हमारा रेवेन्यू कम होगा. विजयवाड़ा मछलीपट्टनम में हमारा रेवेन्यू कम होगा. हमारे नॉर्थ इंडिया में जो प्रोजेक्ट है, हमारे महाराष्ट्र में जो प्रोजेक्ट है, हमारे एमपी में जो प्रोजेक्ट है, ये सब हेवी रेनफॉल एरिया होता है मानसून में. तो उसके कारण ये प्रोजेक्ट का रेवेन्यू और हमारा ये हमारी गाइडेंस से कम रेवेन्यू नहीं है. हमारा टारगेटेड रेवेन्यू था कि इस साल जो हमारे प्रोजेक्ट जिन एरियाज में है वहां कितना मानसून होता है, तो जो हमारा टारगेट था वो लगभग इतना ही था कि हमारा 1500 to 1600 करोड़ का रेवेन्यू Q2 में आएगा, वो आया है लगभग.
Sir, one last question related to this only. Sir, ye samajhne ki koshish kar rahe hain ki as because order inflow is saal thoda kam hota hua dikh raha hai. So is it like we have slowed down the execution or it's nothing like that?
Chalo karo na. Hamari jo order book hai wo 24000 crore ki net order book abhi bachi hui hai.
तो आप अगर देखेंगे तो हमारा जो स्ट्रेटजी पास कई ईयर से जो स्ट्रेटजी हमारा कि जितना हमारा टॉप लाइन टारगेटेड होता है उसका लगभग 2 टू 2.5 टाइम्स हम लोग ऑर्डर बुक मेंटेन करते हैं जो अभी भी हम लोग मेंटेन कर रहे हैं। तो हमारी ऑर्डर बुक के अकॉर्डिंग हमें हमारा पेस स्लो करने की बिल्कुल जरूरत नहीं है। हम जो रेवेन्यू ग्रोथ की जो गाइडेंस देते हैं अकॉर्डिंगली हम आगे के फाइनेंशियल ईयर में पूरा काम कर पाएंगे।
ओके एंड सर एनी इफेक्ट ऑन इंक्रीज इन रॉ मटेरियल प्राइसेस ऑन द मार्जिन दैट यू आर इन्वेस्टिंग राइट नाउ और यू आर कंफर्टेबल एट 17-18% लेवल?
On same line, we are comfortable.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you. The next question is from the line of Priyanka Biswas from Nomura Securities. Please go ahead.
Good evening, sir. Just one question from my side. So regarding the...
Sir, thoda loudly bolenge. Awaaz nahi aa raha clearly.
Good evening. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Now I can hear you better.
So on the financial closure side of the HAM project, so what has been the typical, let's say, the financial profile? As in, like, what are the banks that are essentially lending? Just not to you, but effectively for the industry as such.
Sir, इसमें mostly PSU banks और कुछ private sector banks हैं जो lending कर रहे हैं तो profile आपको देखना है तो जैसे देख लोगे तो mostly तो PSU के करके आते हैं और फिर कुछ private sector banks हैं। मैं discuss करना है detail में तो आप बाकी लोगों से पूछेंगे तो वो भी अपने अपने bank बता पाएंगे, हम अपने बात कर सकते हैं कि हमारे but वो once all our projects are completed then we'll talk about कि हमारे individually banks and all का।
Okay, that was all from my side.
Yes, sir. Yes, thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Parakshit Kanpal from HDFC Securities. Please go ahead.
Sir, any recovery from Topworth or SL? Kya hai status wahan pe? Hello.
No, sir. Usme abhi aisa kuch nahi. Hamari provisioning uspe chal rahi hai, but aisi koi hame abhi at this moment we are still in talks, but aisi koi abhi recovery nahi hai abhi is quarter ki.
Is quarter kitna provision kiya hoga uska sir?
35 crores, sir.
Acha, regular crores. तो आपने जो केपेक्स बोला था 400 से 500 उसमें 100 माइनिंग का है ना, मतलब उसमें बाकी रोड्स का है ना, कितना था उसका ब्रेकअप? मिस्टर संभव
सर, 400 करोड़ हमने स्टार्टिंग में भी रोड के लिए स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द ईयर में भी बात करी थी कि हमारा रोड बिजनेस हो जाएगा और 200 करोड़ का हमारा माइनिंग में ऐड होगा। आप ये देख लीजिए।
ओके सर, ये मेरे को लास्टली चीज पूछना था, आपने जो बोला कि डेट रिडक्शन में आप 2000 करोड़ का इन्फ्लोज पकड़ रहे हैं एडवांसेस से और शेम का भी पकड़ रहे हैं, तो उससे तो मतलब बहुत ज्यादा डेट रिडक्शन हो जाएगा, मतलब
इक्विटी भी हमारा इन्वेस्टमेंट भी होगा, हमें प्रोजेक्ट पे और भी इन्वेस्टमेंट जाएंगे, प्रोजेक्ट का रनिंग बिल भी चलेगा तो सारा उन्हीं होके आएगा, वो तो जो हमें आना है सब हम वो आपको बता रहे हैं, बट उसके साथ हमारा आउटफ्लो भी तो जाएगा ना, प्रोजेक्ट भी तो जो चलेंगे और उनमें जो इक्विटी लगना होगा और उनमें और जो काम होना होगा वो सारा चीज चलेगा। प्रोग्रेस के लिए तो आगे इन्वेस्टमेंट करेंगे ना, और सर
तो मतलब अगर ये 2000 स्पिल ओवर होता है नेक्स्ट ईयर में तो थोड़ा डेट फिर आपका वापस बढ़ सकता है, मतलब मार्च के लेवल तक ना आ पाए शायद,
ऐसा बोल सकते हो सर, बट वी आर एंडेवरस टू मेक श्योर दैट हमें इसके मार्च के लेवल इसके नीचे आना है। और वैसे भी आप देखोगे एब्सोल्यूट इसको दो तरीके से आप देखो, अगर हमारा हम लोग अगर 2500-3000 करोड़ हमारे टॉप लाइन बढ़ा रहे हैं पर हमारा डेट लेवल वहां हो या यहां से वहां से अगर 10% भी बढ़ रहा है तो भी मतलब ऐसा देखो कि 2500 करोड़ रेवेन्यू करने के लिए 250 करोड़ का अगर आपके अगर मैं मैथ के हिसाब से चल लूं तो 250 करोड़ का बना डेट विच इज ग्रेट कम्पेयर टू अगर आप जिस अमाउंट ऑफ वर्क बीइंग डन की बात करें तो, क्योंकि इन्वेस्टमेंट भी करेगी कंपनी सब कुछ करेगी, पर हमारा तो एंडेवर है कि उसी नंबर या उसके नीचे आएगा तो हम उसमें उसी पे काम कर रहे हैं।
ओके ठीक है सर, दैट्स इट फॉर माय साइड, थैंक यू।
थैंक यू सर।
थैंक यू। It's a follow-up question from the line of Devashish Mazumdar from Edelweiss. Please go ahead.
Thank you very much for the opportunity. Sir, existing jo HAM projects ka execution chal raha hai, uska current quarter ka revenue booking agar thoda bata dete.
Sir, aise humne separately nahi bataya, par agar aap hamara current, hamari presentation dekhoge, to usme humne unke sare project ka progress dikha diya hai. To aapko usse bahut clearly dikhega ki progress kaisi chal rahi hai. To wo bahut clearly aapko acche se dikhegi, unke milestones apke kitne complete ho gaye. Sare projects, matlab, मैं अगर देखूं तो जो सबसे पहले स्टार्ट हुआ था वो लखनऊ सुल्तानपुर जहां पे आप लोगों ने विजिट किया था, उस प्रोजेक्ट की प्रोग्रेस 83% आ चुकी है। अपन लोग लास्ट जब मार्च में वहां गए थे, कई लोग यहां से आपके से भी गए थे, तो अपन 40% प्रोग्रेस पे थे और अभी उसकी 83% प्रोग्रेस हो चुकी है, जो हमारा दिसंबर या जनवरी में हमारा प्रोजेक्ट हमारा हैंडओवर भी हो जाएगा। which will be done 1 year before scheduled commission date. For a 2,000 crore project being done 1 year before scheduled commission time. So similarly, baki project bhi dekhoge, to within year mein dekhoge, to 60% ki progress sabki aa gayi hai. Jo even jo ek saal pehle hue the, unko 60% ki progress aa chuki hai. So project at a very high progress level, aur kaam is going well. But to give a breakup of revenue is not possible right now.
Okay, no problem. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Here's a follow-up question from the line of Anupam Gupta from IIFL. Please go ahead.
So just on the stops work and SL after...
Anupam, you're not audible. Can you be a bit loud, please?
Yeah, I'm asking on the Topsworth and SL outstanding. After all the provisions which you have made, what is the outstanding balance from these two accounts as on date? Hello?
Sir, just one sec.
Yeah.
Sir, I think 200 to 200 assets badi, but I can get back to you on that number.
Total is 200 from both, right?
Haan, matlab uske aaspaas ka yoga uske andar mein hi, uske andar mein I have to recheck and try and get back to you on that, hai na sir?
Fine, okay. Yeah, thanks.
Thank you. We have a follow-up question from the line of Aditya Mongia from Kotak Securities. Please go ahead.
Thanks for the opportunity again. I had one question on the order inflow guidance. See, this thing you have a 6% share in terms of market share, in terms of ordering so far. There is a 1 lakh crore opportunity which is in front of you. Why are we assuming a small 4% share in this incremental opportunity, which is leading to a 4,000, 5,000 crore kind of number? When we have, in the road sector, kind of achieved high single-digit market share, low double-digit market share in the past. So should we be taking this as a sign of DBL trying to slow down the number of order wins incrementally? How should we take it in?
No, sir. Basically, DBL always is not in the business of building orders just for the sake of having 5x or 6x orders. We have the requirement that we order. And when we have starting of the year ka guidance, we are talking about that. We have order change in this order. So, if order government 10 lakh bhi de de, to usme thodi ki main 10 lakh ke order ko apna business plan change kar dunga. So, government, alle 1 lakh order de ya usse kam ka de, hum to apne guidance pe stick kar rahe hain jo humne starting of the year ki baat kari thi. That is not material ki government ka kaise kya change ho raha hai, nahi ho raha. And we are not in the business ki that we want to win a certain percentage of orders from the government. That is not what DBL's strategies are. DBL's strategies ki internal hamare kya capital hai, hamare kya manpower hai, hamare kya equipment hai, uske basis pe hum kaise grow kar rahe hain, kya kar rahe hain, uske basis pe kaam kar rahe hain. Not on ki external ka kaise kya chalega.
Got that. That's helpful. If you could share the number of acceptances from your balance sheet at the end of first half, that would be useful.
Sir, which type are you talking about?
The acceptances number, which was about 800 crores or so, 800, 900 crores at the end of FY 2018. If you can share the first half number.
Give me one sec, sir. Sir, it is around 850.
Sure, sir. Those were my questions. Thanks, Rohan and team.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, due to time constraints, that was the last question. I would like to hand the conference over to the management for their closing comments. Thank you, and over to you.
Thank you very much, all our partners, for joining in on the call. And in case anybody has more questions and they want to understand a bit more, so we feel free to reach out to our IR team and our internal team so that we've been more than happy to help out in anything that you may need. Thank you again for all of us from all of us here at the DBL team. We thank all of you for coming on the call.
Thank you very much, members of the management.